jump in and let us see what is happening in the world of Democracy 3. As I have previously mentioned, we are going to be starting a brand new campaign, and we are going to be playing as America, the United States of America. Got a couple of mods installed, doesn't really make that much of a difference. I've got an ongoing series as Scotland. If you're interested in that, then, you know, check it out in the description just below the video. There's a link to my YouTube channel there in case you want to see that. All right, so basically, Democracy 3 is a game that centers around, I don't know, controlling population by introducing policies, trying to control opinion, getting elected. It's really, really fun, actually, and it's very, very good. Okay, so what do we want to change here? I mean, I think we probably want to be the Socialist Party, right? I imagine that is probably the Socialist Coalition. You know what, that's good enough for me. The Socialist Coalition, the Socialist Party, that's fine. I'll take it any day. We can be up against the Conservatives or the Republicans. Somebody that's fairly right-wing. Yeah, you know, some sort of right-wing party. I think, just looking here, the Freedom Party, I suppose that's quite an American concept, isn't it? We can go for that. Earthquakes, hurricanes, I will take all of that. Term length is 4 years, that's cool. And there's a maximum term limit of 2. Okay, so the difficulty. Should we ramp the difficulty up a little bit? You know, I think we probably should. And I think innate socialism should be, like, I don't know, 10% or something. I think that's probably about correct. Innate liberalism. Yeah, that's cool. That's cool. Okay, let's jump on in and see what we've got going on. I'm excited. I want to see what's going to happen. I'm hopeful that we're going to be able to do it, that we're going to be able to accomplish our mission. But at the same time, it might not happen. Congratulations on your election victory. Welcome to your new job as president. The lives of all 316,668,000 citizens are now in your hands. Cool. Great. Let's begin our term in office. See what we've got to deal with. So we've got a whole bunch of negative stuff that I'm not super thrilled about. Let's be frank, right? On the positive sides, positives are easier to cover because we've got much less of them. Many fewer green dots than we do red dots. So we've got the technological advantage thanks to our space program and thanks to our high levels of technology. It's very nice to see. We have an absolute truckload of debt. We've got a deficit of $558 billion per turn. Wow. Okay. That is quite something. Capitalists don't actually hate us, although we've got such high levels of debt that it seems a little bit crazy that they would like us, but whatever, I guess. We've got some antisocial behavior. We've got some alcohol abuse. We've got some internet crime. We've got some vigilante mobs. Oh my goodness gracious me. We've got ghettos. Ghettos, really? We've got some asthma epidemic stuffs going on. And of course, we've got the obesity crisis. And then up here in the top right-hand corner, we've got homelessness. Right, so how do we go about fixing all of America's problems through the wonders of socialism? Good question. Well, it's execute the liberals. Well, you never know. You never know. That may end up happening. No, I don't. Liberals are actually very interesting characters. Yeah, they pretty much concentrate on the law and order side of things. They don't really believe in economic policy. So yeah, as people have correctly identified, let me just move this to the bottom. There we go. It doesn't really show up very well, does it? Oh, crap. I'm just editing a few little things up here. That can go like that. Chat box. The chat's going to be fairly transparent. It's going to be fairly difficult to see, but I hope you'll forgive me for that. Yeah, I mean, have the homeless live with the liberals. Then burn the houses. Jesus Christ, guys. Jesus Christ. Yes, that's exactly how we're going to solve the situation. We're going to solve it in three primary ways, right? These are my three primary ways that we're going to spread socialism through the lands of Lady Liberty. We are going to try and introduce a social housing program, okay? So at the moment, we don't have any public housing, right? And this is how we're going to do it. We are going to say, hey, we are going to introduce a state housing program, okay? So that's what we're going to do. It's really laggy. That may be a problem at your end. I upload at quite a high bitrate because this is probably going to go on YouTube in good time. There is third-party websites, I think, that you can watch Twitch in slightly lower quality, but I don't know them. You know, that's just a couple of times that I've heard about that. Anyway, let's introduce state housing. So, obviously, our biggest factor in this is that we're gonna be really pissing off capitalists. You know, we're really, really gonna be pissing off capitalists a lot. But at the same time, it's gonna cost a shit ton as well. Now, for America, right, $133 billion, that's pocket change, right? That's pocket change. But that's a lot of dosh, considering that we've already got a deficit of $558 billion. I think, you know, we could be in some sort of trouble. Now, something that is a modded extra, that is something that I really did like, the basic income guarantee seemed to be very, very effective, and I would love to get the opportunity to implement a policy like that. So currently, we get 25 political capital per term, which is going to put us on 37 political capital. It's not going to be enough to implement the basic income guarantee, but you know what? It wouldn't be the worst idea in the world to save up a little bit of political capital to try and get that. Credit rating has been downgraded. That's not good. Capitalists are not going to like that. Our interest rate is going to rise, which means that our expenditure is going to rise. You know, no duh, that's what happens. Our debt is going to rise even faster. So, right, over the next couple of turns, we need to introduce some key policies. Obviously, one is going to be the... Oh, homeless assistance program. I didn't see that there, actually, but that's something that we're probably going to introduce. What was I saying? The basic income guarantee. Yeah, we don't have enough political capital at the moment for it, but we will soon. How much political capital are we going to get next turn? 25. We need to spend at least 12 so that we don't go over our maximum. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. But basically, we need to find a way to cover up this... Whoa. We need to cover up this huge, massive deficit. Now, primarily, the way that left-wing governments go about covering up deficit is to grow the economy through the use of expenditure. Now, let me give you the bad news. The global economy is doing very, very well at the moment. Which, in this game, at least, means that it is going to go very, 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 very badly. Very, 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 very soon. There's going to be a lot of just going down stuff that is going to be happening, which is not something that I'm super thrilled about. So, we are going to have to, unfortunately, raise taxes by quite a considerable amount. So, I don't want to say we need to double taxes, but we pretty much need to double taxes. We need to double taxes and then some, right? So, currently, we're sitting on $566 billion. And we need to go at least to 1,100, which seems a little bit of overkill, doesn't it? We'll go up to 61%. There we go. 61%. That is very, very crazy. Lower interest rates. That's actually a really, really good point. It's a mechanic that I've not really played around with. In which one is interest rates? It is around here somewhere. Where are interest rates? Do I have to introduce the policy or will they just be around? Inflation. Where's the interest rates? It's going to be an economy. Interest rates. Money supply interest rate. Yeah, so I need 25 political capital to introduce that. So, yeah, that's what we're going to do. That's a really good idea. And it's not something that I completely understand, but raising taxes is going to be the first part of our plan to, you know, try and cut the deficit. Lowering interest rates, of course, will mean that it is cheaper for investors to borrow money and therefore invest in our economy, which should, you know, try to offset the predicted decline of the global economy, which is almost certainly going to happen. By the way, if you've got any suggestions how I should play, policies that I should introduce, then, you know, by all means, please, you know, shout them out. Shout them from the rooftops. because I need to hear them. So as you can see, our income shot up there, right? And that is still not enough. It is absolutely not enough. So I think we're actually going to do it. We're actually going to say, hey, fuck it. Let's introduce interest rates. And also money supply. In a time of economic downturn, which is what we're going to be doing, we are going to shoot the money supply up. We're going to give it a little bit of a heroin injection, so to speak. So low interest rates, it's going to lead to slightly higher inflation, higher purchasing power, but it is going to reduce poverty. And yeah, you know what? I think this is something that we can get on board with. It's going to cost us a lot of money. It's going to cost us a lot of money. But lowering interest rates, I think, is the fundamentally right thing to do. Once again, if we have a look at our debt, it's going to continue to increase. And certainly, socialist governments in the past haven't really been that bothered about it. But as you can see, debt interest currently accounts for 4.1% of our spending. Yeah, debt interest currently accounts for 4.1% of our spending. That's nothing, right? 4.1% of our spending, pretty much nothing, okay? I mean, like, military spending, that's a lot, right? That is a shit ton. But 4.1% is not much. However, it is going to continue to grow. And that is not something that I'm super, super over the moon about. Children's food. We're not going to regulate. Well, in fact, you know what? We are going to regulate because, you know, I was thinking, you know, in America they don't tend to regulate very much, but at the same time we're a socialist government, so we are going to regulate. Need Weimar Republic like money printing. Yeah, I'm not really a huge fan of hyperinflation myself, but you know what? Some people might be. Let's go to the next turn so that we can actually get the ability to get the money supply, which is what we're really after. Superhero, crime and violent crime down. Well, that's very, very happy. And a credit rating has been downgraded even further. That's pretty bad, actually. That's really, really bad. If we have a quick look at our expenditure right now, we can see debt interest has now gone up to 7.1% of our expenditure. That is not something that I'm super over the moon about, I'll be honest. And I don't think we gained enough political capital. No, we didn't. We're 2 political capital off from the money supply, which is thrilling. Absolutely thrilling. We need to spend a little bit of political capital. So, in fact, you know what? No, we're not. We're just going to fucking beeline for a debt protection law. We are going to limit agency activity. Yeah. Yeah, we're going to basically beeline for getting this money supply. And it may be a total, absolute disaster to pick up this money supply right now, but at the same time, I think it's worth it. So we're going to be releasing the Kraken. It's going to absolutely shoot up our inflation, but at the same time, GDP is going to be going through the frickin' roof. And our GDP really does need that 20% increase. That's going to really take it up, and hopefully it's going to take income up with it as well. Oh man. Yeah, I'm not thrilled about that whole sort of thing. Investigate those credit rating companies. Yeah, we're gonna crack down on them hard. We're gonna crack down on them very, very hard. Got 10 political capital to burn. Is there anything that we sort of really want to do? Well, another thing that we're gonna have to do is probably try and introduce public healthcare. Because public healthcare is, I don't know, I want to say a cornerstone of socialism, but it's not really. It's just a feature of many, many socialist governments and whatnot. They've got public healthcare. Oh man. Well, you know what? If we had a real economist, that would probably actually help. That would probably help. We've still got all of these societal problems that I would really love to solve, right? I really would. I mean, ghetto seems to be solving itself. That's great. That's good, I guess. But internet crime doesn't seem like it's solving itself. Antisocial behavior, it's coming down slowly, but it could be going down faster. Asthma is definitely not solving itself. And obesity is completely dependent on a whole number of things. Curbing immigration really isn't that much of a problem for us at the moment. I mean, where is immigration? Which one is it? Racial tension is linked to immigration. So where is immigration? Here, that one. Yeah, immigration is actually going down over time. We've got fairly strict border controls, and You know what? I'm actually not super worried about immigration at the moment. Like, I think it's absolutely fine. It's fine. Yeah, we're gonna be spending a shit ton of money basically on our money supply. It's gonna cost us a lot of dosh to do this, but I think it might be worth it. 160 billion for this increased economic benefit might be something that I can get on board with. Let's go to the next turn. It's risky. It's risky. It's very, very risky. Credit rating has further been downgraded. Our GDP barely went up, even after all of that political capital and money that we've invested in trying to increase our GDP. That makes me worry. That makes me worry really, really hard. Still running this deficit. Income is just not enough. As you can see, as our interest rates increase, our expenditure is just going to go through the roof. I mean, debt interest is now 9% when it was 4% a couple of turns ago. Oh man. This is not great. This is not great. How crazy would it be to introduce a couple of new taxes? I don't really know. Like, a carbon tax would be maybe not the craziest thing in the world, although I don't even know if we've got a maximum political capital enough to introduce a carbon tax. I don't know. I really don't know. Is there any tax that sort of are good? A religious institution tax only brings in 1 billion. Not worth it. Tax auditors, really not worth it. High-tech products tax, barely worth it. Punitive tax on superstores, not really worth it. Public tax returns, nope. Nope. Punitive wealth tax, no. Automation tax, potentially worth it. It's a lot of money that it can take in, but pretty much nothing, right? Pretty much nothing here can. Health tax credits. Yeah, that's potential cost. We don't want that. Pretty much nothing here can bring us in a large enough amount of money. Luxury goods tax, potentially. An internet tax. A graduate tax. An airline tax. What about a carbon tax? How much can that introduce? How much can that take in? 590 billion. That's actually something that I would be very, very interested in. Or a flat income tax. That's also something that I would be very, very interested in. I don't know. I don't know. We can actually build walls around luxury homes. Where is it? It is called. It's over here. It's somewhere. It's gated communities, I think. I can't remember where it was. Yeah, I can't remember. Torture used by Secret Service. Holy cow. Wow. Yeah, I can't remember where gated communities actually was, but there is an option. Somewhere indeed. Yeah, well, the poor like us. I think that's kind of nice. Homelessness, we're not really solving that quickly because state housing is still being rolled out, and it's going to take a while. It's going to take a lot of time. It's going to take a lot of time to do that. But hey ho. I think we're just going to go to. I don't want to waste political capital by going to the next turn, but I don't know. I'm not entirely sure. Pollution, is there anything that we can do about the environment? Not really at the moment. I'm just. How do we progress our socialist ideals without having a successful economy? That is the real question. We don't even have enough political capital to raise the income tax further. And even if we did raise the income tax to the absolute max, still gonna not be enough to cover our deficit. Whoa, stress epidemic. Cool. Okay, you're not very keen anymore. Our debt is continuing to rise. Our expenditure is continuing to rise. We're showing no signs of stopping. How did our GDP do actually there? Our GDP actually went up by a shit ton, in fairness. So next turn, we should be collecting a lot of dosh, a lot more dosh. So I think this is probably a good opportunity to introduce another tax. What tax we can do? Well, we probably are just going to go for the tax that is going to net us the most dosh, I think. I mean, we don't want to lead to brain drain, but at the same time, we need something to prop us up. We need something, and currently there is nothing. Internet tax. An automation tax is something that gives a decent amount of cash, but at the same time, you know, it's not something that I'm super behind. Okay, let's introduce the automation tax. Let's try and get 100 billion out of it. I think that's quite a nice round number that we can aspire to. Yeah, there we go. So capitalists are going to get annoyed with us. Capitalist income is going to go down. Trade unionists are actually going to like us. And industrial automation is going to go down. It's also going to decrease our technology, which is going to stop us having this technological advantage eventually. Have I ever heard of the war tax? War tax in what regard? I mean, historical war taxes or actual war taxes within the game? Because I'm fairly certain that war taxes within the game don't actually exist. People always comment about the Ireland potato famine whenever they're in conversation with me. They always bring it up, and I have no idea why. Well, I know exactly why they bring it up, but it seems ridiculous to me. But anyway, let's go to the next turn. Whatever. Let's go to the next turn. There's an ethnic plot against us. Well. What have I done? I genuinely don't know what I've done. I genuinely don't know what I've done. I do not sound Irish. Fuck right off. I really do not sound Irish. But anyway, yeah, we've got an ethnic plot against us. Not something I'm super, super, super thrilled about. No, this is not appropriate. This is not appropriate. This is not appropriate. Oh, man. Oh. Well, we're still running a deficit, even though our income is increasing. Which is so bad. It's so darn bad. Okay, let's raise our income tax pretty much as high as it'll go. Let's raise it to 80%. Okay? Once again, upsetting capitalists even more. But at the same time, next turn, for guaranteed, we are going to be on top of our deficit situation, which is kind of nice. Freedom of information. You know what? We will propose it. There we go. And let's go to the next turn. Because why not? Hey! Survivor! They say some politicians are political survivors, but you really define the word with the way you keep dodging those terrorist plots. Here, have a shiny medal. Fantastic. Okay, so there was a failed assassination attempt of me by the Black Power Group. Well, fuck. Okay, and our GDP takes a little bit of a plummet. Please tell me that we're running a surplus. Oh, thank God. Thank God. Jesus Christ. Okay, finally our income is above our expenditure. Our debt will finally start to go down. Fucking hell. Okay, we need to try and make sure that the Black community really don't hate us. Holy shit. Holy cow. Okay. Oh my God, Jesus. You've been killed every time I've played the US. Yeah, I can understand that. The ethnic minority at the start of the game have a very, very, very high chance of just killing you. And the reason is pretty much because of ghettos. And while that does go down, it takes a long, long time to go down. And that's a 16% reduction in how much ethnic minorities actually like you. Invest in watermelons. Yes, I can read, actually. Send in some Navy SEALs. You know what? I would love to send in some Navy SEALs, but apparently the Secret Service are the people for me, supposedly, protecting me. Yeah, our debt interest is costing us a shit ton. So basically, imagine if we just had no debt. then we wouldn't have to pay this horrendous 200 billion fine each turn. That seems absolutely absurd. Military spending is something that we should probably scale back on, although we can't because, you know, it actually costs more political capital to lower our military spending. Make an old person tax. I don't actually think there is an old person tax. Yeah, I don't think there is an old person tax. What a shame. Yeah, no, there's not an old person tax. I think it just comes under the general sort of tax. But yeah, we're being targeted fairly heavily by groups of an extreme nature. The Battenberg group, I reckon they're going to be the people that polish me off. They are basically capitalists that are just unhappy with me. They really are very, very, very fucking bad for us. Bad for business. Remove the NHS. We don't actually have an NHS. We're playing as America, so the state healthcare service is, well, if you can call this an NHS, then that's something at least, but this is nothing. This is absolutely nothing. This is a bare bones of what a public healthcare service, this is a bare bones of what the NHS is in the UK. See what happens if you make alcohol free. The plebs will drink themselves to death. You can't really make alcohol free, technically. You can reduce the taxes on it. I mean, look at the problem that we've already got. We've already got alcohol abuse, like, at a max. It's increasing the amount of money that we have to pay to the state healthcare service. It's increasing crime, and it's decreasing health. So, we've already got a situation where people are just drinking themselves to death. Quick, research anti-gravity. It will lift the situation. Whoa, how funny. How funny. How funny indeed. We can actually introduce anti-gravity grants if we wanted to, but I don't really want to, I'll be honest. Not really thrilled by that. What else? What else can we actually do? We really cannot afford to piss the capitalists off even more, but I'm going to make an estimation, right? I'm going to make a guess. The capitalists will have polished us off by the end of the next two turns. I guarantee you. I guarantee you. That's what I think is going to happen. Seems that our money sort of supply did seem to work. Inflation is climbing, however, which is not the best thing in the world, I guess. But, you know, GDP is boosted by the money supply, which is kind of nice. I guess we've got to go to the next turn. And it's a ballsy next turn, because once again, a failed assassination attempt. The Black Power Group, once again, are trying to assassinate us. That's very, very bad for us. GDP is going down the shitter. There is a superhero. Vigilante mobs has ended, however, and we've now started having a little bit of a water shortage. We've also started having a little bit of a brain drain because we've got such a fucking high income tax. And you know what? There's absolutely nothing we can do with it. There's absolutely nothing that we can do about it. So brain drain is just going to sit in here. It's going to decrease the number of capitalists, which I suppose is kind of nice, actually. But it's going to decrease our productivity by 10%. It's also going to reduce our GDP by 10%. So, you know, overall, that's fantastic. That's absolutely beautiful. No, that's terrible. It's really, really bad. I don't think this is fixable, I'm afraid. This is very, very, very unfixable. Conservatives, though, they fucking love us for some reason. I don't understand why. Is it perhaps just because we've been shot at so much? I mean, potentially, I guess. You know, I always think that this picture of euthanasia looks like a massage parlor. Like, it doesn't look like assisted suicide to me. Looks very, very like, very, very like this guy's getting a massage. Pretty nice massage it looks like as well, so, How about retry with the easiest nation that you can pick? Well, the whole point of playing a difficult nation is because it's a difficult nation, not because it's an easy nation. But I don't know, I did increase the difficulty to 200%, so I suppose that's why everybody is so very, very sensitive. People are very, very sensitive. Toll roads. Capitalists. Fuck, no, this is road building. I want toll roads. Where is toll roads? Nope, achievements. I don't want this. Although this is kind of cool. This is kind of cool. Let's go and try and implement toll roads. In fact, how much political capital do we get per turn? A maximum of 28. Holy shit. Holy shit, that is not enough. That is really, really bad. Let's fire our entire cabinet and hire a bunch of new people. Hopefully some socialists. Oh shit. Fucking hell. I just reshuffled the entire cabinet. Jesus Christ. Oh, bloody hell. We just need some socialists on board. Somebody that is actually going to help us out and give us a lot of political capital, please. Even if they are slightly shitter. There we go. Come on, I need some. I'll take you. You know, you're a liberal environmentalist. That's cool. Environmentalist state employees. That's cool. You're on board as well. I just don't want any capitalists, or preferably not conservatives as well. Farmers, liberal. Liberal parents. I'll take you. And then for transport, I'll get... I'll probably get you, actually, yeah. So, we're going to get a fair amount of political capital next turn. It's not going to be pretty, because we're probably going to die. Almost guaranteed. Yep. Thought so. I did think so. I did think so. Am I surprised? Not really. Not at all. Not at all, actually. Let's go and take a look at the awards that or the awards, the achievements that we can sort of go for. Socialist Paradise is obviously the one that we were going for there. Technological superiority. Potentially. A police state. Okay. A police state is probably something that we're going to be going for, actually. Or perhaps a free market paradise. Maybe. I don't know. I don't know. Like, is there anything that people really want to see? I don't really know. I mean, there's a whole bunch of stuff here, and if you see anything that you fancy going for, then I think we can probably do that. I'm open to suggestions. Without a shadow of a doubt. Inebriated society. Wow. You've played this game and got Green Nation, Police State, and another one. Yeah, I've played this game probably a lot, probably for over 50 hours now. I've got a fair amount of stuff, I suppose. It's kind of nice. Kind of nice. A police state. I would kind of like a police state, actually. Don't know. Popular leader? Maybe, potentially. A budget balancer. A budget balancer. That's the word that I was looking for. Surveillance society. A divided society. Educational failure. A lot of good stuff here, actually. A lot of good stuff here. Start a new game. I wanna try as the USA again. You know, I wanna try as the USA again, except this time, let's go for just normal difficulty, and let us try and go for a capitalist utopia. So, something that is, you know, much, much more capitalist friendly, I guess. So, the first thing that we could probably do is we could probably say, hey, we need to try and reduce expenditure, because that is typically what capitalists do. So, let's just try and slash, and I mean absolutely slash, military spending, right? This is going to give us a huge fucking surplus, an absolutely huge surplus. It's also going to mean that patriots are a little bit annoyed with us. It's also going to mean that unemployment probably jumps up by around about 20%. Yeah, who would have thought? State pensions? State pensions aren't going to be a thing anymore because as capitalists, we don't really believe in state pensions. In fact, if we've got enough political capital, we can probably try and get rid of it. So we want to try and find anybody that's socialist in our government and we want to try and kick them out because we don't really need them. Yeah. Okay. So we've got however many turns. We've got 32 turns. 32 turns to make this a reality. Socialists are going to be annoyed at us, as they typically are when we are playing as a capitalist sort of group of people. But hey-ho. Okay, our credit rating is bad. That's actually all right. Like, that's actually not too bad, because we're reducing our expenditure and we're massively increasing our income. Fire the environmentalists. The environmentalists don't really make that much of a difference to us. I mean, I'll fire them if it becomes a problem. I mean, if they are, you know, in the way of whatever we're trying to do, then they will absolutely get fired. But for now, I think they're all right. So, how do we go about trying to make the capitalists happy? Wow, we have such a small surplus at the moment. It's going to take a long-ass time for military spending to reduce. 8 turns, in fact. That's quite significant. That's quite significant. What do socialists like? Socialists like food stamps. I think we can cancel food stamps. You know what? I think we can cancel food stamps. Yep. Yep. We're going through the process of just removing a whole bunch of stuff that is currently state-owned. So private pensions is currently in effect. We're going to cancel this as soon as we have enough political capital. But it takes a long time. It really takes a long time. Over to Potato, have you ever had, while playing this game, had no red and a couple of green bubbles? Yeah, of course. I have that currently on my Scotland playthrough. I've played this game for tons of hours. Like, genuinely, check out my YouTube channel. There's a whole bunch of Democracy 3 on there if you're interested. Kill the state pensions. State pensions are getting killed next as soon as we have the political capital to do so. It's probably going to be 2 turns of saving up. Children's food, we are not going to regulate children's food. I do believe that capitalists are not happy with regulations. Our GDP is starting to go down. Let me quickly check to make sure that we are still making money. Yep, we're running a surplus right now, which is very, very nice to see. And actually, our debt is starting to decrease, which is somewhat impressive and unexpected. But alas, that is the reality of the situation. So I think we're running into a little bit of a problem here, right? And the problem is that we are not going to have a high enough maximum amount of political capital to actually get rid of state pensions, right? Which is very, very problematic for us. Because it's going to cost 49 political capital to do that. So we're going to have to try and get... I think we're probably going to go for a cabinet reshuffle, actually. I genuinely think that is the right port of call. And then we're just going to rehire a bunch of capitalists. I think conservatives and capitalists are what we want. You're a youth and you're a capitalist? Welcome on board. I just need capitalists. I need a lot of capitalists. A lot of capitalists. Yep, we'll take you. Tax, who wants the tax job? Anybody want the tax job? Seemingly nobody wants the tax job as a capitalist. You want the tax job? Welcome aboard. What about public services? Anybody for the public services job? You're sort of not that bad. You're alright, I suppose. Yeah, congratulations. Welcome on board. Law and order. Who wants to take up the Lord at Lord? The law and order briefing. Anybody? Not particularly. I suppose we'll take you. We'll take you, yeah, but anybody else with a transport that wants a transport brief? Liberal and environmentalist. Well, oh shit, yeah, I'll take you, actually. Yeah, I'll take you. Okay, so quite a lot of political capital that we're going to gain next turn. We will skip straight to the next turn because we want to save up. Ban alcohol adverts. We're going to reject the ban because, of course, in a political society, then, you know, why would that not be allowed? You can advertise alcohol all you want. Okay, income is looking good. Debt is going down. And fingers crossed we'll be able to improve our credit rating very, very shortly. You know, I'm not super hopeful, but it is potentially possible for that to happen. Capitalists are liking us, apparently. That's very, very good to see. 49 political capital is the amount of political capital we actually need. We need to spend a little bit of it to make sure that we don't lose such a large amount. Now, limit automated trading. This is something that we can get rid of. Yeah, we can just totally get rid of this straight away. There's no limits. There we go. Perfect. And now, when we get our 26 political capital, it's not going to go over the maximum by as much. So we're not really losing that much. Now, there's a lot of groups that are fairly annoyed at us. I'll grant you that. That's absolutely fine. Ghettos are working on their way down. That's kind of cool. We can probably actually put a little bit of money into our police service. That's something that we haven't really talked about. You know, doing anything with the police, unfortunately. But hey-ho. Doing something with the police is not something that I really care about at the moment. What I really care about is getting rid of this absolutely abhorrent state pensions nonsense. Yeah, it's going out the window. Absolutely going out the window. It's going to save us a lot of money. And currently, I think, while we might as well, we're going to allow the agencies to operate, because why would we regulate anything? You know, currently at the moment, we're sort of prioritizing getting our debt down, which is perhaps not the right idea, but it's the idea that we're sort of going for. Now, we're going to start to run up against a significant amount of opposition. Credit rating has been upgraded. That's great. Capitalists like us. GDP is increasing. Everything is going hunky-dory. That's nice to see. Nice to see. Even in a time, I feel, of economic slumpage, we're starting to see our GDP, you know, staying level. So we are probably going to increase our expenditure towards the police. Maybe the intelligence services as well, actually. I don't quite know. I'm not entirely sure. But yeah, I don't know. What else makes the capitalists unhappy? Labor laws they're fairly in favor of. Capital gains tax. This is a nonsense policy. It's reducing GDP, for goodness sake. Yeah, you know what? Let's take that out of commission. Why not? Make it illegal not to own a gun. Where is gun control? Here. Handgun laws. No limit. That is, patriots really, really like that. Yeah, wow. And liberals really don't like this. I don't understand liberals sometimes. They're fairly, fairly strange. But this is pretty much a non-issue. We're not really concentrating on the difference between, you know, liberals and patriots, or liberal people and religious people. We're more concerned about the fact that, you know, capitalists aren't getting what they want. And, you know, we are a mechanism for capitalists to get what they want. Now, what else do capitalists not like? They don't like sales taxes. Well, this is going to get cancelled very, very shortly indeed. Unfortunately, it is going to take a chunk out of our surplus, but at the same time, hey-ho, what can you do? A superhero. Crime and violent crime are all down, and a high productivity scenario has developed, which means that our GDP is increasing, self-employed is increasing, capitalists are liking us a little bit more, and self-employed income is increasing a little bit more. Great to see. Very, very nice to see. However, the Revolutionary Army, the Socialists, are not very happy with us. They are very, very grumpy. Very, very grumpy indeed. Yeah. I suppose we could probably cancel technical colleges. Perhaps. Zafias 4 or IV? It is the potato. It is the potato himself. I am here in the flesh, coming to you from your computer screens or your iPads or your cellular devices. But I am here. I am here in the flesh, playing a little bit of Democracy 3 on somewhat of a short stream. Well, it's not really a short stream. You know, we'll probably just do a couple more playthroughs, maybe one more after this. But that's about it. So technology colleges, socialists really don't fucking like. They're really upset by the fact that there's, like, no equality as well. Yeah, so gated communities, wow. These are really, really not great. We should probably cancel gated communities. Yeah, I don't think that's something that we really want to have around. We want to try and appease the socialists if we absolutely can. Labor laws, they're very, very pro-employer. I don't think we can really do anything here. Did I give up on Beyond Saul? No, not as of yet. I'll probably do another couple of episodes. Why? Do you like it? What am I going to do after this? Well, not very much. Probably going to have my dinner. That's what I'm probably going to go and do. That's why it is rather a shorter stream. But anyway, we need to try and appease the socialists. Yeah, they didn't really like that debt protection law shit, did they? Yeah, and they don't like how poverty is so darned low. State schools. Well, we can cancel the state schools if we want to. And you know what? We probably might. We probably might. You were the one that commented on the last video. Oh, thank you. I really appreciate everybody that comments. Well, I hope you have a nice dinner. Well, thank you. I'm not going quite yet. I mean, we can calm down a little bit. It's all right. It's all right. Not don't count me out quite yet. Does anybody have any crazy suggestions on what we should do? Because while I'm doing well, I feel that I could be doing a darn sight better. And maybe you guys out there have an idea of what I should be doing. We're going for a capitalist state, so to speak. Capitalists don't like pollution controls. Let's get rid of these pollution controls. Why not? Yeah, they cost us money anyway. Go to Mars. Maybe not. Maybe not. Not super thrilled with this whole go to Mars thing. What's our largest expenditure now? State schools is now our largest expenditure. No, I'm not thrilled about that, I'll be honest. I'm not super thrilled about that. Let's go to the next turn. Let's go to the next turn. Divided society. Oh my goodness. Wow, what an achievement to get. Who says equality is a bad thing? You have driven a wedge the size of a football stadium between the haves and have-nots. Congratulations. Don't mind if I do. A failed assassination attempt. The socialist army is attempting to try and kill us. Credit rating has been upgraded. Capitalists are liking us. GDP is increasing. Crime, however, is also increasing because we got rid of gated communities. Still running a surplus. Debt is going down. That's exactly what we like to see. Unfortunately, there is just no way to appease these socialists, apparently. I don't know. There's a lot of stuff that socialists really should like. I mean, if I'll raise legal aid. Maybe that'll get them back on board. I raise foreign aid, will that get them back on board as well? Not really. I mean, we need some good stuff. We need some good stuff. I mean, there's not much that we can actually do. I mean, state schools are going to be deleted next turn anyway. Which is going to be crazy. It's going to be very, very crazy. Just look at the number of people that we have hating on us. Like, it's impressive. Like, we've not even talked about the Black Power group or ethnic minorities in this game, and already they're hating us. Wow. Maybe we should fund the intelligence services a little bit more. I mean, potentially. Yeah, it's probably a good idea, actually, the more I think about it. I mean, fuck the liberals' opposition to that. Socialists aren't happy unless you go Soviet all the way. Socialists are really, really difficult to appease. They're very, very difficult to appease. And once again, assassinated by the socialist people that are just permeated throughout our society. Yeah, so not great. Absolutely not great at all. We got an achievement, though. We got an achievement. That's kind of nice. That's really, really annoying. Like, how can we counter that? I don't really know. I mean, if we take a look at our compass, I mean, you can see Scotland. Where were we as the United States? Where were we as the United States? We must have been fairly up here. Yeah, but obviously we didn't win a single election. Which is annoying, but you know, it's the reality of the situation sometimes. I really do want to keep on trying USA, because the USA has got such a great sort of, I don't want to say system, but it's really very, very difficult. I find it quite challenging. I suppose we'll sort of go as the Republicans. Yeah, why not? We'll go as the Republicans. We'll try again for that whole sort of capitalistic feel, except this time we'll go for a no term limit. I know that's a little bit cheaty, but I think it's fine. If we just go at a little bit of a slower pace, I think we might be fine. So once again, we sort of want to start off getting rid of all of our military spending. Yeah, I think that's exactly what we need to do. We just can't afford to have that expenditure hanging over us. And this time, we need to try and implement policies that socialists are actually fans of, right? Let's leave the law unchanged. So we need to try and ensure that socialists don't hate us like they normally do. And I don't know if there's a way to increase equality. I don't know if there's a way to increase equality without introducing new policies. Did I try the new political machine? Well, you, sir, you clearly have not checked out my YouTube channel over the last couple of days, because I did a video, actually. Probably the, in fact, I think it was the first video on the political machine, 2016. I've got a review up on Steam of it. I played it on stream a while ago, on Wednesday. Yeah, I played it on stream 2 days ago. It was really, really good fun. And I'm starting a series on the new political machine from this Monday, I think. I haven't quite recorded it yet, but I will indeed be playing around with that even more in my spare time. So, without a doubt, yes, I have seen the new political machine. I do like it. It is exactly the same as the last two games. But I suppose that's just life, I guess, isn't it? You know, remaking games and whatnot, but whatever. Yeah. Oh, man. I think we can also afford to get rid of this sales tax. I think we can afford to get rid of this sales tax straight off the bat. Can I have your Steam username? I don't... You can Google me, but you can Google me. You can search my username on Steam, although I probably won't accept. I do have a few requests. I don't usually accept Steam friend requests from just random folk, but by all means, you can search up and see what I've got. I think I don't think my profile's on private, because who really cares anyway. Anyway, back to business. How are we going to deal with this? We've got this deficit that we want to clear up, but at the same time, you know, that's understandable, because we did cancel the sales tax. We did cancel it. What can you expect? It's just now about waiting for this military spending to actually just decrease, so that we actually just get all of our money back. It's kind of what we're hoping for at the moment. We're gonna... Do we want to go for a political reshuffle? I don't think we do, to be honest. I think, you know, we'll just keep our cabinet as is. A flat tax is not great. Like, a flat tax is really not good, because capitalists don't tend to like flat taxes. I haven't added you in about 2 weeks. I'm sorry, guys. I'm sure you can understand somebody in my situation. If I keep on getting added friend requests, then the people who I'm actually friends with, I need to search so freaking long down my friends lists for, that it's just makes the point of a friends list not even worth it. You know, I'm sure you can understand that. Yeah, GDP is going down. It's going down, GDP. GDP is going down, I'm yelling timber. You better move, you better dance. But poverty is going down, though, thanks to the elimination of that dastardly sales tax. Not something that I was super, super thrilled about. Our income did actually take a really big nosedive there. And our debt is increasing. Yeah. Okay, so I think this time we're going to need to try and once again go for the money supply. Go for the money supply, all right? Increase inflation, increase GDP. It's going to take 2 turns to activate, but I think it'll be worth it. Ban alcohol adverts. Let's reject the ban. Is anybody hating on us? Not really. There's a lot of members of groups, which is not great, but at the same time, it's not the absolute end of the world. But it's still bad. Yeah, let's go to the next turn. We need to try and implement this money supply. Credit rating downgraded. That's a majorly bad event for us. And there's an environmental protest that is going on. Two events that I'm really not very happy with. But alas, what can you do? Sometimes you just can't do anything about it. Now, we want to spend a little bit of political capital. And we probably want to spend it on something that is going to make capitalists a little bit happier. So, environmentalists, really not keen on us. Really, really not keen on us. Let's scale back road building. A, it's going to save us money. B, it's going to make environmentalists happy. Unfortunately, it's going to mean that we do have a higher amount of traffic congestion, but that's fine. Oh, I see you want Rise of Nations. I had that game when it came out. Memories. Yeah, I know. I just sort of add a bunch of games that I think would be good on the channel. So that's why they're on my wish list there. And pollution controls is also something that we're gonna get cancelled, because we need the extra little boost to our GDP, and also capitalists are really pissed off with us by it. It does provide a little boost to the environment, but I don't really think the environment is our top priority at the moment. I mean, making the capitalists our best friend, that is our top priority, ladies and gents. So GDP has shot up because of our money supply. We did indeed implement that policy. We also got rid of the pollution controls, which gave us a nice little, 3% boost or whatever the hell it was. And over the next couple of turns, we should be hoping that our income jumps up above our expenditure. But out with that, we need to try and scale back on stuff like state pensions. And I would be really very, very comfortable if I could just cancel out the entirety of state pensions. But unfortunately, I can't do that at the moment because my political situation is terrible. We basically don't have anybody that agrees with us in our cabinet. And that's not something that I'm super thrilled about. I'll take you on board. Don't mind if I do. I just want a whole shit ton of capitalists. That's literally all I want. Capitalists with high amounts of political capital to give me per turn is definitely something that I want. Yep, I'll take you. Tax. Who wants tax? Who's a capitalist and who wants tax? Well, nobody really. I mean, you're all right, I suppose. You're all right. You're all right too. Liberals don't really seem to like us. I'll give you the job. There we go. Public services. Who wants the public services job? You want the public services job. You're an environmentalist and you're a capitalist. Wow. How do you deal with that? That must be very, very conflicting for you. Wow, we've got a fuck ton of environmentalists in here. I'll take you. Yeah, we've got way too many environmentalists in here, unfortunately. That's annoying. Transport. Who wants the transport brief? You? Yeah, I suppose you, although you're really going to get pissed off at me. Very, very quickly, in fact. Let's go to the next turn. Ban tobacco efforts. Let's reject the ban. Let's go to the next turn. We'll try to save up. Oh, thanks for the socialist plot. Already a socialist plot against me. I've done nothing to upset the socialists. Crime is up. Poverty is up. Unemployment is down. Kind of nice. I've done pretty much nothing to upset the socialists. I mean, look at that. It's basically the same level. That's so stupid. So stupid. Well, you know what? Balls to the wall. Balls to the wall. Let's eliminate state pensions. Cost us a shit ton. Oh, shit, we can't. We don't have enough political capital to do that. We will next turn, though. We will next turn. Let's go to the next turn. Allow agencies to operate. Let's go to the next turn. And then let us... a failed assassination attempt. Fucking fantastic. Health is at an all-time low. Crime is actually kind of very low, actually, because of our superhero. Our credit rating is unfortunately still trash, which is going to make capitalists a little bit annoyed with us, but hey-ho, you live and let die, I suppose, don't you? And what were we actually going to introduce? We were going to introduce the, well, we were going to introduce, we were going to revoke state pensions. Because they pissed off socialists. Now, socialists do really quite like the unemployment benefit, although, yeah, I guess it's not that great. Also, it's important to note that the unemployment benefit does actually, at least in this game, increase unemployment by a little bit. So I think that's quite cool, how that sort of mechanic works. Fuck's sake. Fuck. Fuck. Fucking hell. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Well, GG everybody. G fucking G. I really can't do anything about it. I mean, they are very, very over the top. Very, very over the top in terms of being annoyed at me. I mean, everybody saw right there, right? I did almost nothing to the socialists. In fact, I even got rid of the sales tax, which is hurting equality, and that helps the capitalists. Not the capitalists, the socialists. So, really, I'm very, very disappointed with that. I'm very, very disappointed in that. How about I try Canada? I did Canada a long, long time ago on my YouTube channel. Long, long, long time ago. And I think I did really well, actually. Well, you know, I've played all the countries, like, multiple times, but, you know, that's why I've got mods. But I think I did alright in Canada. I really can't remember. I really cannot. But that just really, really annoys me, that fact. You know, the fact that socialists, at least within this game, are super, super, super ready to go at you at the slightest opportunity. Man, that's really, really annoying. That really is very, very annoying. And I know there's probably more that I could have done, but I guess you sort of just got to assess your priorities in these games. Like, what policies do you want to prioritize? And maybe we just... I didn't even feel like we were aggressively helping the capitalists. I mean, obviously that was our long-term goal. But I feel that we were slowly helping the capitalists, but at the same time, we weren't really upsetting the socialists. And I don't understand how that's the case. I really don't. Okay, let's try something a little bit different. Let's try sticking it on maximum easiness mode. Now, fingers crossed, that actually means that it's going to be... There we go. Fingers crossed, that means that it's actually going to be a little bit less annoying to deal with. Because we are going to try it one more time. I did say that I was going to try it only three times, but you know what? Let's try it again. As our last time. So, I'm not entirely sure what decreasing the difficulty actually does, but, you know, once again, we're going to go for a fairly standard opening strategy, decreasing military spending, because it's completely unnecessary and very, very daft. Okay. Children's food. Leave the law unchanged. Right? Socialists, are you pissed off at me? You probably will be very, very soon. Let's get rid of the tax. What tax is it? Was it the sales tax? I think it was the sales tax that... Sales tax, yeah, increases. Yeah, yeah, we want to cancel this out as quickly as possible. Even though it does leave us in a 290 billion, you know, dark hole or whatever. Whatever. I'm okay with that. Abolish the income tax. Abolishing the income tax is something that I want to do, right? I absolutely do want to do that, but there's a couple of other taxes that I want to get rid of first. And if our economy could be, you know, just like so super duper stripped down that we didn't require like any money to just stick into anything, then that would be pretty much the ideal situation. So our GDP did fall. That's fine. Health is falling. That's not great. Poverty is actually falling because we reduced the sales tax. So, is this going to feed into something? The Communist Party, the membership of the Communist Party is up. We're not going to rush it, but we are going to go fairly slowly. Cancel the pollution controls. so that we can get an extra little boost to our GDP. That's fine. What else do capitalists not really like? They like private prisons. Well, I'm glad they like private prisons. What about if we increase our funding in private prisons? I mean, might actually not be the craziest idea in the world. And holy shit, liberals actually like private prisons. Who would have thought? That's actually kind of awesome. We're running a crazy large surplus at the moment, which is beautiful. Are we going to be running a surplus forever? You know what? No, we're not going to be running a surplus forever. However, I think, I think the reason that we're running a surplus is because the difficulty's on easier. I presume that's why we've got less of a sort of, you know, we don't have three grand billion of debt like we did in the normal version. I really do not know what the difficulty actually changes, but I'm hoping that it changes the socialists' tendency to just, like, attack us. You know, and don't forget that we've got this surplus to burn through, so we can burn through it. Capital gains tax, that is going. That is absolutely going. Capitalists don't like property taxes. Well, you know what? Maybe next turn a property tax is going to be abolished. We will reject the ban. Why not? Environmental protest, that's great. I don't care. GDP is fine. Credit ratings upgraded. Beautiful. Unemployment's up, unfortunately, but only by a bit. And crime is down by a little bit. That's cool. We are in good shape budgetarily. Our expenditure is decreasing, which is exactly what we like to see, because obviously we're going to try and, you know, like, literally just strip down our economy to as basic as it can be. Unfortunately, that means that we are going to have to completely eliminate the space program. As much as it pains me to do so, it's a way of spending money. So, gotta go, I'm afraid. Gotta go. State pensions is next on the list of things that are going to be annihilated. State pensions is interesting because it doesn't actually decrease the number of, doesn't decrease the amount that socialists actually like you. It just decreases their membership. So that's fine, I guess. The maximum political capital that we've got at the moment is 44. So not a thrilling situation to be in, but not a terrible one either. Unemployment continuing to rise. Not fantastic. Anybody starting to challenge us? Not really, actually. Not really. The Communist Party is the only party that's got a significant sort of presence there, which is kind of nice. Yeah. Income tax is definitely on the list of things to be abolished, as I previously talked about. But there's a whole lot of things on the list to be abolished. I think we should probably just say, hey, we need to try and get rid of this as soon as possible, and then we need to try and get rid of this as soon as possible. But obviously we're reducing military spending in line with everything else. And, you know, after military spending, state schools and state healthcare will both be scrapped. That is something that I can guarantee you about. To do that, we're going to actually have to increase the maximum political capital that we have access to. So we're going to have to reshuffle the cabinet, which is a little bit bad, right? A little bit bad, but, you know, that's life sometimes. That's life. And we will try and have we'll try and put a team together that is very, very responsive, very, very cool, and I've got a lot of political capital to give me every turn. So there's a shit ton of environmentalists, right? There's a shit ton of environmentalists, unfortunately. And that's not something that I really want to have the privilege of choosing between, because any environmentalists that we pick up are going to be very, very difficult to deal with. Tax. Who wants tax? A liberal environmentalist? Wow. You know what? As long as they give me a lot of political capital now, I suppose I'm okay with this. Farmers, religious. Yeah, that's cool. Maybe law and order. Maybe you, a conservative and a trade unionist. God, wow. We're selling our soul out here for all of this political capital that we're getting. Wow, even a socialist on our fucking team. Jesus Christ. Well, holy cow. Don't say that I'm not inclusive. I am very, very inclusive. We are going to allow these dead agencies to operate, and we're going to head to the next turn with that. Remember, we've got a view to reduce, which we can actually do right now, actually. We've got a view to introduce or reduce state pensions by just cancelling them. There we go. Suddenly, we're doing even better. And we've just saved ourselves a shit ton of money. Military expenditure will continue to fall all the way down to $18 billion, which sounds like a lot, but for an American government, pocket change. We need 42 political capital to actually cancel schools out, which is something that we're going to do as soon as we actually have the political capital to do that. Socialist plot is happening, apparently. We've got a drug addiction that's also developed. A stress epidemic. I always love that scream. Stress epidemic that is not something that I'm super thrilled about. But yeah, once again, we're starting to see the construction of the enemy groups that are willing to kill us. That's not something I'm over the moon about. Let me tell you that. Not something I'm over the moon about. Anyway, next turn. Next turn means, a failed assassination attempt. God damn. God damn indeed. That's not thrilling. Exactly. Who needs state schools? A very, very daft lefty idea. We don't have 60 political capital. Why not? Let me guess. Because of somebody. You. I didn't think you would be very sympathetic. Oh, just wait. Just wait. It's going to happen. The assassination is going to happen. But until it happens, let's try and get rid of the state schooling system. Because why not? Why not? Like, where the hell is it? Oh, let me just go to expenditure. I'll check it out in expenditure. State schools. There we go. Okay. Anything that this does is pretty much irrelevant. We'll just cancel the policy. And there we go. We did it. We just got rid of it. And next on the list of things to absolutely shave up into a billion tiny pieces, probably road building. Road building is probably a fairly easy way to get access to yet more cash. Now, I wouldn't really expect to survive this turn, but balls to the wall. There we go. There we go. There we go. You know, I've said it before, I'll say it again. It's very, very difficult as the USA to actually do anything because this is a completely unrealistic situation. You know, America is super, super unbelievably protective of their president. There is no way in hell that I would ever be killed by a socialist tribe. Not to mention the fact that there is an unholy absence of socialist tribes in America anyway. So, that's annoying. That's really very, very annoying. But hey-ho, you know, what can you do? Sometimes that's just how it is, I guess. That's just how it is. We're going to be finishing this stream up here. This stream is going to be going on YouTube. Unfortunately, we didn't have much success. We did get a couple of achievements. We did get one or two, so I can be a little bit happy about that. But if there's any other democracy content that you're interested in, you know, leave a comment on one of my more recent democracy videos, and I will be sure to do it, because I'm probably going to end up doing a Socialist USA playthrough on a video. So, yeah. Please tune in next time, because I would absolutely love to see everybody here that was here for this little stream. And yeah, my name is Noble Potato. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.